Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video, we show you how to use flexible limits in your application. Even though our products are purpose-built, we understand that every application is different and you might need to adjust the controller to fulfill the application requirements. We know that every application is unique, so we want to make your life easier. First, let us take a look at all of the customization tools available to you when using our XT controllers. We have Logics Manager, Analog Manager, Localization Tool, Modbus Master Functionality, Telegram Mapper Software, Flexible Limits. So, here we have the full list of the options, but today we are going to focus on the last entry, Flexible Limits. Our easygen XT units offer 40 flexible limits. They may be used for limit switch functions of all measured analog values. Connect to your easygen XT and enter the password. Navigate to Parameters. Then go to Configure Monitoring. And here you can find the Flexible Limits menu. These are all available flexible limits. Additionally, flexible limits 33 to 40 are disabled in idle mode. Let me show you flexible limit 1 as an example. Here is the description. Here you can enable or disable the flexible limit. This is the threshold setting. When the monitoring will trigger the limit, you can select overrun or underrun. This is the limit value. Here we have the hysteresis, the delay. You can choose the alarm class here. This is self-acknowledge setting. Here you can choose if the flexible limit is delayed by engine speed, or logic flag, or always active. And here we have the source value setting. Additionally, the flexible limits 25 to 32 have one more setting called fallback time to use in load shedding application. Here, you can see it. And here you have the flexible limit explained. Now, let us see on our simulation tool how the flexible limit would work in a real life situation. Here we have our simulation tool. You can see right now I have one generator connected. I have some load connected here, and we are parallel to mains. EasyGen is sharing the load with mains. Here we are connected to this generator with toolkit. Let us configure a flexible limit alarm when we are exporting power to the grid. We will go to configure analog manager. Let us first configure the mains power value to kilowatt value. We should find the value in watt here. Here we need to multiply this, so let's choose multiply function. The other input we should choose as 1. And here we enter our constant to change the value to kilowatts. After that we click apply. And here we can see that we import 20 kilowatts right now from mains. Now we shall configure the flexible limit with our kilowatt value. We will configure the first flexible limit as an example. So, we enable the flexible limit and set it to 0. Because when we are above 0 kilowatts, that means we are exporting power to the grid and we want to have an alarm. As a source, we should choose our newly configured analog value. And click apply. Now I am going to simulate a power export situation by disconnecting the load. Here you can see we are still importing some power. Now I will open load breaker. This, as you can see, initiated our flexible limit because for some moment we were exporting power to the grid. If you want to open the main circuit breaker in case of power export situation, this is how you can do it. You need to go to General Mains Decoupling setting and change this parameter to MCB. Then we set up an external mains decoupling to activate with our flexible limit. And now, we can do some testing. Let's open the load breaker. As you can see, the easygen opened the MCB as soon as it saw export power. This is all about the flexible limit. I hope you enjoyed our video. Make sure to check our other training videos as well.